By now, you know that R&B singer R. Kelly gave an explosive interview with CBS's Gayle King about being charged with 10 counts of criminal sexual abuse against underage teens as young as 13. What Kelly said made headlines, but what struck me just as much was what he wasn't saying, but what his body language was telling us. And I wanted to examine it closely, but with an expert. So joining me now is body language expert Janine Driver. She's the president of the Body Language Institute. She has spent 16 years as a DOJ law enforcement officer and now works with lawyers and judges, the ATF, the FBI, the CIA, the DIA, and the International Association of Chiefs of Police. Janine, I want to do what I like to say, Zapruder the tape. So let's start with the relatively calm part. I'll roll it and then we can discuss.
Play. All right, Michael.
Have you ever had sex with anyone under the age of 17?
No.
Never.
No.
What are you seeing in that, Janine?
What any human being watching will see, Michael, which is he's trying his hardest to say no, but his body language and his head gesture, I've never seen anything like it this dramatic. So he's starting with a no and it turns into a yes. And when I speak in corporate keynotes, I make the whole audience of 10,000 people, I go, everyone look at the person next to you and say, are you happy to be here, and say no. Or say yes. His body language is leaking the truth. Our brain doesn't want us to lie, and it comes out like this.
Okay, I think in this next one, he does the opposite. Yeah. Let's play it, and then you can comment.
So they're lying on you. That's your explanation. They're lying on you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Janine, what are you seeing?
Absolutely. 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 So we see him shaking his head no here. Well, he says absolutely. He says it three times. And even more importantly than shaking his head no here is his tone and pitch begins to go down, down, down. And when someone is being deceptive and they're lying, you'll often hear an increase or a decrease in their pitch, Michael. We saw this with Britney Spears when she told Matt Lauer years ago, my marriage is not in a crisis. She goes, no, it's not in a crisis. 2 weeks later, she files for divorce. Boom. This change in tone and pitch, 85% of the time when we're lying, there's that increase or decrease. So we see body language and a change in pitch.
There were times that he doesn't answer the question at all. I've got one of those queued up for Janine Driver. Play it.
So I think the point you're making is, and correct me if I'm wrong, that you have never held anybody against their will.
That's stupid. Use your common sense. Don't forget the blogs. Forget how you feel about me. Hate me if you want to, love me if you want, but just use your common sense. How stupid would it be for me to, with my crazy past and what I've been through, right now I just think I need to be a monster and hold girls against their will, chain them up in my basement, and don't let them eat and don't let them out unless they need some shoes down the street from their uncle.
I mean, it was a simple yes or no question, and he never gets to the answer, correct?
Oh my gosh, this is like body language detecting deception gold. So he does smoke screening here, doesn't answer the question. The best answer here with any question, when a yes or no is involved, the strongest answer is simply a yes or no. So he does this big smoke screening and just goes crazy. We saw something similar with, remember Governor Sanford? He left the country with his mistress in Argentina. Roger Clemens
Appalachian
up in the
Trail.
Hill. Yeah, I'm Roger Clemens up in the Hill lying about taking steroids. Had Andy Pennant told me, had I knowingly knew then what I now know now, this talking in riddles, this stalling technique, this smoke screening is indicative of people who are keeping the truth from us.
Do you know that when you were on my SiriusXM radio program this week, there was more reaction to something you said about Gayle than what you said about R. Kelly? Now, I'm going to play the tape. I don't want to give it away on CNN. Talk to me about Gayle. Play it.
All right, so Gayle right here, look at her toe is going to go up. And when we see our toe go up, this is, see her toe, look at her foot. This is excitement.
I see it.
So she knows this is interviewing gold. She's like, oh my gosh, I couldn't have scripted this better. Jussie Smollett couldn't have written a script any better than what's reality here. Her toe goes up, this is excitement. And at one point we even see her smile and laugh and she remains completely calm. I give her, listen, if there was an Oscar right now for interviewers, it would definitely go to Gayle King. She remains calm. She doesn't flinch one bit. She's excited about what we see here. That toe going up.
Okay,
so if you're on a date,
what about
It's good news.
What about, yeah, what about in a general sense, the toe going up? I think I just cut you off. You were about to offer the payoff. Go
right.
ahead.
Right. Well, if you go on a date and the woman's shoe suddenly goes up, it's defying gravity. It's, I'm so excitement, my shoe can't even stay down. It's like Joey from Friends used to be like, how you doing? That eyebrow flash. This is excitement. Gail knew it and she killed it. I was very impressed.
Okay, the most animated part. I think what I'm going to do is put you on a split screen, take down his volume, and have you walk us through what Janine Driver sees. Do it.
I didn't do this
All
stuff.
Right. Okay, so he's hitting his chest right here. These are called illustrators, and it's congruent with what he is trying to convince us of, which is he's angry. This is legit anger. He stands up. Look at this. I want everyone to notice at home. Do you see how he steps away from Gail? This is actually right here. It's this distancing. This is what we see with aggressiveness. Before someone attacks, you'll often see a step back. I'm Janine Driver, the mother of three sons, the wife of Leif Larson. But when I take a step back, this Janine's going to punch you in the face. I'm impressed with Gail remaining calm. This is genuine anger. If we were to compare him to Judge Kavanaugh, Judge Kavanaugh was kind of pushed to be more aggressive because his first interview was a little too passive and it was really staged anger. This is legit anger, but this is likely connected to he's going to jail. He's not going to see his kids raised. And so right here we get this, the illustrators match what he is saying. It's just
okay, but
not connected,
Janine,
with lying.
Why isn't this the legitimate angry reaction of someone unjustly accused? You know, how would you expect someone who's unjustly accused to react?
Michael, you're a smart cookie, and I love that you asked me that question. We're looking for clusters. So we're looking for multiple clusters, and what we see with R. Kelly is shaking his head yes when saying no, shaking his head no when saying yes. He does shoulder shrugs, which are uncertainty. And what he's talking about here is he's not being direct, saying, I didn't do this. They're liars. See, what happens is when someone is lying on television, look at the Roger Clemens of the world, they won't come out and say to Brian McNamee, you're a liar. And what we hear right here is R. Kelly is not coming out saying, she's a liar, and she's a liar, and they're lying. They're not coming out and saying it. This is what liars tend to do. They just say, I'm a victim.
Final question on a totally different subject, but like many others, I was transfixed by that Michael Jackson documentary. I know you scrutinized one of the accusers, James Safechuck. I've got a short clip. Play it. Let's ask Janine Driver what she thinks. Real brief.
Fundamental. Fundamental.
What are you seeing there, Janine?
I call this the BCN. When you bite your lip off to the side, Michael, it is bad events happened, concerns or negative thoughts. This emotion in this little expression is not something we see when people are lying and staged their emotion. I came in thinking these guys are lying and wanted money, and I walked out saying, oh my gosh, these guys are telling the truth.
Can somebody who has done bad things engage you and come off as compelling? I mean, could you teach this to some bad scene?
I would love liars to come to me, because here's what happens, Michael. You remember the truth, you're telling us the lie, and now you can't unsee, unhear, or unexperience what I share with you. So the liars totally fall apart, because you're like, oh my gosh, I did the shoulder shrug. And you start to analyze yourself. As a matter of fact, the more liars that come to me, the more I teach them, the more they're not going to get away with it. And we're going to keep people safe and protect your friends, your family, and your finances.
Okay, I'm out of time, but Jussie Smollett, credible or incredible?
Unbelievable. Body language gold. I did a four-hour documentary where I decoded every single step, put it on YouTube so people can go there. Or every Wednesday night, I do a Facebook Live show called Celebrity Lie Detector Live, where I broke
him
down.
Okay, but give me the bottom line. Come on, what's the bottom line?
Bottom line, this guy is a liar. It is scripted. He literally, I'll give you a quick tip. He said, we tussled. We implies a relationship. Anytime someone is attacked, they never say we. We tussled. And if someone's attacking you, then it is not called a tussle. Before the brothers even got arrested, I came out and did a Facebook Live saying he knew it. It was scripted. He said, attack me over by the stairs. And what happened? Lo and behold, everything I predicted was true.
Janine, thank you so much.
Thanks, Michael.